Hi, everybody. You caught me while I was coloring my coloring sheet for this week's lesson. Sometimes I find that I do some of my very best thinking when I'm coloring. And I'm kind of thinking big thoughts right now. Have you been hearing a lot about racism and anti-racism? Maybe in your families, maybe on the news. I've been hearing a lot about it too. And so I'm trying to learn a bunch of new things. And as a church, we're going to be talking about some of the letters that the Apostle Paul wrote way back right after Jesus died. And the reason that this has to do with racism is because racism isn't new. Racism was going on in the time of Jesus and even before them. Now, sometimes racism in those times looked a little bit different than it does today. But in those times, the Jewish people sometimes didn't like the people who were non-Jewish. The Samaritans didn't like the Jewish people. The authorities thought that everybody should just be Roman and all of the authority should be to whoever was leading the Roman government. So even though these are not new problems, they're problems that have been hard for people for a very long time. And the Apostle Paul is super interesting because he started out on one side of the argument where he didn't like any of the followers of Jesus, and he was even mean to them. And then all of a sudden he had this really amazing experience where God spoke to him through Jesus. And then he became somebody who not only was following the way of Jesus, but he became somebody who was very interested in spreading the word that God loves all of us. God loves all of us the same. And that there is no group of people, Jewish people, non-Jewish people, men, women, slaves, non-slaves, there's no group of people that deserves to have a better life than any other group of people. And that God wants nothing more than for all of us to be this gigantic family that is deeply in love with one another and deeply in love with God. So you see, these are really big thoughts for us to take on. And we're going to do this through talking a lot about the letters that Paul wrote. And in traditional worship, they're going to start with the book of Ephesians, which is a letter that Paul wrote to the church of Ephesus. Now, at the beginning of that, like I said, he talks a lot about being adopted into this big family of God. And I was lucky enough to spend a little bit of time earlier this week with the Velvetosky family. And Olivia was kind enough to give me some of her thoughts on what it is to be adopted and to adopt someone else and to have enough love in your heart for everyone. So let's take a look at what Olivia had to share.
Let's read about Paul's letters. So our sermon series is about the book of Ephesians. And Ephesians was one of the letters that Paul wrote to some churches that he started. Look at who do you think that is? His name's Paul. And this says Paul's letters. Paul's job as an apostle was to tell the story of Jesus to everyone he met. He traveled all over his part of the world and started many churches with people who believed in Jesus. When Paul could not travel to visit his friends in Rome, he wrote them a letter to share God's love. He said, "Dear Christians in Rome, there are three things I tell people who have never heard about Jesus or God. Jesus was human, like us, and also God, both at the same time. Jesus came so people in the world would know how much God loves us. Believing in Jesus and knowing God's love changes your life. Everyone should know this good news. Are you telling people this good news too? The peace of God be with you. Paw. Who is that?
Snowball!
Snowball! Can I hold Snowball? I already love Snowball. Who do we have next?
Bobo!
I remember Bobo, don't I? Yes, can I hold Bobo? How about if Bobo's right here and Snowball's here? Now, who's that?
Luna!
Luna? Where should Luna be? I don't have room anymore for Luna. Oh my gosh, I am way down now. I have Luna and Bobo and Snowball. Now, here is the big question, Olivia. You adopted all of these guys into your family, didn't you? Yes, you did. Here's the next one. Do you love any of them more than the other ones, or do you love them all the same?
I love them all the same.
You love them all the same? How could that be? Do you have that much love in your whole heart?
Yeah.
That much love? You're sure. Show me with your arms how much love that is. So much love. Now, can we bring somebody else special in onto our blanket? Who else could we bring onto our blanket right now? Can we bring baby Maddie onto our blanket?
Yeah.
Yes, let's bring baby Maddie and maybe a mama with baby Maddie because she's little, right?
Love soft things.
Oh, she does love soft things. So about 5 months ago, six months ago, this new baby came into your world, didn't she? And so your family went from having one child to two children, right?
Yes.
Yes. And I was with you the first time you saw baby Maddie. And how did you feel about her?
She was so cute.
She was so cute. And did you love her right away?
Yes.
Yes. And was there enough love in your heart to add baby Maddie to all of the love that you already have for all of these guys that you already adopted?
Well, wanna see how much love now I have?
Please. Oh my gosh, it keeps getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Right? The more things that we have to love, the bigger our heart gets and the more love there is in there, right? Do you know what, Olivia? I think God is like that too. How do we want to pray? Do we want to pray with our hands up like this? Or do we want to pray with our hands crossed like this? There's lots of ways to pray. Okay. Okay. Of course they can. Should I hold their knees like this? All right. So we'll hold our buddies' knees like this. And how should Mama hold baby Maddie? Look at her. Oh, she's got baby Maddie crying too. Okay. Are you ready?
Sure.
Okay. Dear God, thank you for all of the love that you have, and thank you that we can adopt so many into your forever family and know that there will always be enough love for all of us.
That was Luna.
In your name we pray. Amen.
Thanks again to Olivia and Maddie and Aaron Belbatowski. It was so fun to see you guys. And I hope that everyone has a super great week. And we'll see you next time, okay? Bye-bye.